Hello everyone, welcome to my Facebook Live. I am Ruth Norton with Ruth's Stamping Corner, and sorry, I'm just trying to adjust everything. I thought I was gonna be late. It's so good to be with you guys today. I have a really cute little box to share with you guys today, a really cute little treat. Look how cute this is. So cute. We're gonna make this in just a second, but before we do, I just want to go over everything that's going on. We have just about a week left of a couple promotions. Our designer series paper sale, we save 15% off nine designer series papers in our annual catalog. This sale ends on August 2nd, so a week from tomorrow, I believe, is August 2nd. So you only have about a week left to take advantage of this sale. So if you haven't stocked up on those DSPs that you love, make sure you stock up on these DSPs. There are some amazing DSPs. I am loving so many of these patterns, so stock up while they are on sale. It's a great time. All right, the Paper Pumpkin Hope Box, that is August Paper Pumpkin. That will be available until August 10th. You can subscribe and get it by August 10th. It is designed by our co-founder, Shelly Gardner. It has 9 cards and coordinating envelopes, comes with a ink spot, an exclusive stamp set, and I think you can see a little bit of it on the box right there. I think it's going to be a gorgeous, gorgeous kit, so don't miss out on this one. I'm going to tell you guys a lot over the next few days until August 10th. Don't miss out on this one. This one's going to be a good one, so don't miss out on it. All right, my paper share, there's a link to it in my video description, but my paper share for the mini catalog and the celebration catalog is open right now. I will start sending invoices to those who have already RSVP'd for it. Those will start going out either tomorrow or Wednesday. So watch for those coming in your inbox if you've already signed up for it. If you haven't signed up for it, it is not too late. You can absolutely get in on the paper share. And there are some gorgeous patterns. You can see some of them on the covers here. Some of my absolute favorite Christmas patterns, I think, in a long time. And some really amazing Halloween patterns too. So and then just some like year-round patterns. They're not all specific to the holidays. So make sure you RSVP for my paper share. It is $42. You get 9 packages from in here. You get a bonus, free bonus from the celebration catalog. It's just a great, great deal, and it's a great way to just sample all of the papers without investing all that money all at once. Okay, guys. I'm going to be announcing my card crate for August tomorrow. It's going up on my blog tomorrow. I have a few more things I need to finish on my blog tomorrow, but it is going to feature the hand-penned bundle. This is in the annual catalog. It is a gorgeous, gorgeous bundle. So details will be up about card crate tomorrow on my blog, but I wanted to give you guys just a really quick sneak peek of the cards. I don't want to show too much, but I want to just give you guys a really quick sneak peek of the cards. They are gorgeous, gorgeous cards for card crate this month. You don't want to miss this one. This is one of the best bundles, I think, in the annual catalog. And every year, so many times a year, I say the last thing I need is another floral stamp set. And you guys, this is a good one to have. So add that to your stash and make sure you watch for details on card crate going up tomorrow. Again, I'm just finishing up some stuff today, but it should go up first thing tomorrow morning. Talking about the mini catalog and celebration catalog, going back to that, this launches on August 3rd, which I believe is it Wednesday? I think it's Wednesday next week, or is it Thursday? It might be Thursday, which means August 2nd is Wednesday. You guys, August 3rd, whenever that is, this is launching. If you want to add any of these products, if you want them now, if you don't want to wait till August 3rd, you can put them in your starter kit now. Otherwise, you can start purchasing from both of these catalogs beginning August 3rd. I do have a host code for July. If you do want to place an order for July, please use this host code. All orders will receive a PDF with 3 exclusive projects. If your order is over $50 or more, I'm also going to send you a free make and take kit to coordinate with that PDF when you use the host code. This host code is only good through the end of July. I will have a brand new host code up August 1st. All right, you guys ready to make this sweet little box? So inside, there's just some little Kit Kats inside. It'll hold probably a little variety of candies or other things. I wonder if it'll fit a gift card. I didn't size it for a gift card, but now that I'm looking at it, I think maybe it'll fit a gift card. Maybe. I mean, you can fit it in diagonally. It kind of works. It's not really sized for a gift card, though. Let me put that one back. Okay, but it does hold just some little cute little treats. If you just need a little treat to give to somebody, this is a really cute little box. So let's make it, okay? So we're gonna start with a piece of petal pink cardstock, and this is 3.5 by 9. Let me get out my Simply Scored. We are going to score that. Oh, hello. Bang. Okay, we're gonna score this. We're gonna, on the 3.5 inch side, we're going to score it at 3/4 on each side. So I'm just gonna score once at 3/4. I'm gonna flip it all the way around and do 3/4 again. Okay, on the 9 inch side, we're going to score it at 3/4, 1 1/8, 4 1/8, 4 7/8, 7 7/8, and 8 1/4. Now, I know that that's a lot of measurements and there's a lot of eighths in there. All of the measurements are in the video description and they'll all be on my blog later today. This blog post will go up later today. Don't worry about writing them down. They're all going to be on my blog. They're all in the video description. So you can just refer to those. All right. That is one of the reasons that I love our Simply Scored though, because it has the eighth measurements. So it's really easy to get those score lines. All right, we're going to fold and burnish on all of our score lines. I'm using my bone folder. That is your secret weapon when you're making a box. You want those lines nice and crisp. And I forgot to get my what is that called? The detailed trio punch. I forgot to grab that, so I'll need to grab that in just a sec. All right, to do some trimming, we have this little center panel here. We have this 3/4 of an inch. We have these little squares. What we're gonna do is we're going to notch in on the score. So I'm gonna cut up on the score lines, and then we're just gonna notch in on the squares a little bit. These little tabs are gonna go inside your box. They will never be seen, so don't worry about getting them completely perfect because they're not going to be seen. Nobody's going to see them. They're going to be on the inside of your box. This one I went a little crooked. Let me see if I can get a little bit straighter on that. There we go. Okay, now for the top of our box, or for the other sides of our box is going to fold up like this. What we're doing is we are just going to cut out this little corner here. So these two little rectangles, we're just going to cut out just like that. And we're going to do that on all four corners. So just straight cuts here. We don't need to worry about notching in anything. Just cut along those score lines and cut them straight. All right, and I am going to have to grab my detailed trio punch just when I thought I was prepared. Although I think, do I know exactly where it is? I see it. Okay, I can grab it right away. My punches are sometimes a hot mess and I sometimes can't grab it, so give me just one second. Okay. All right, here is my detailed trio punch, and all we're going to do is round these corners of all of those little rectangles we just cut off. We're just going to go through and round all of the corners on those. So just slide that into your detailed trio punch or any corner rounder that you have. Slide that in. If you're not getting a nice curve on your corner rounding, make sure that you're putting your pieces in. There's two sides here to put it up flush against this side and put it up flush against that side. And if your cutting is a little off, you may need to just kind of straighten up your cutting a little bit. Just make sure you're getting a nice straight edge to match up in that corner. All right, so we're gonna move all our trash off. This is what your paper should look like. So it's super easy. There wasn't a lot of trimming, just the corners and then notching in on the sides there. There wasn't a lot of trimming on that. So that's what it should look like. I'm going to use apparently tear and tape because this is my Stampin' Seal Plus right now. Oops, I need to get a refill. So I'm gonna use some tear and tape. I actually have a refill. It's just on the other side of the room. I'm gonna put this along. I should have put it on the edge there. I'm gonna put it on the cut edge here. I'll put two pieces on. We'll be super sticky. Let me peel this one off so I can fit one along the edge. I can't get it off. The take your pick tool is your best friend when you're using tear and tape. You can really peel off those little edges. So let's Just gonna get that under there. Perfect. That slides out really easy. Yay. Okay, now it doesn't matter which side you put them on. These are equal on either side, so it doesn't matter. You just want to put adhesive on one side. Now, we're just going to fold this up. You can adhere these down. You can tack these little tabs down on the inside if you want. But again, they're just going on the inside, so it doesn't matter too much. And we're just going to line this up. I want to line up the top edge so that it's nice and straight. Oh, hello. The top edge. Get it nice and straight. And that bottom edge nice and straight. And I'm going to tack that down. Oops. I didn't want to glue that one down just yet. And we're going to do the same on this side. Just line it up. That top edge straight, that bottom edge straight, and that is the box. These are going to kind of fold down like that. So you're going to kind of push them in, fold them in like that. And then I'm just using some clothespins. These are just, you know, clothespins I have for craft purposes. That's just going to hold them closed. All right, let's fill our little box. So last time I went to the store, the kids made me get this. And so the only reason I can justify buying a giant bag of candy like this is to fill it with treats. So let me find a couple Kit Kats. The Kit Kats, I think, fit pretty perfectly in there. You can use other candies too, but the Kit Kats, I think, are pretty perfectly. You can put two of them in there. Okay, perfect. There we go. So let's decorate the box now. All right, so I have a piece of our brand new Whimsy and Wonder DSP. This will be in our new mini catalog. If you want to get in on the paper share, this is going to be included in the paper share. Let me show you the entire package of this DSP. There are like iridescent foil on it, and it is gorgeous. This is one of the patterns. This is the pattern we're using. This might be my favorite. I just love that iridescent pattern. These trees are covered in that iridescent beauty. And then the holly also have that shine. There's some snowflakes, and then the beautiful gifts. So this is one side of those six patterns that have the iridescent loveliness, and then this is the other side. They are, oops, am I missing one? There it is, right there. They are just gorgeous, and I love these colors for Christmas. I use a lot of pink in my Christmas cards. This one was really, has been my favorite DSP in the mini catalog, so get that in your paper share if you want to be part of the paper share. My DSP is 2.5 by 6, and we're going to stick that on. I'm going to use some Stampin' Seal for this. I probably should use Stampin' Seal Plus, but you guys saw that situation. So I'm just going to put it on all four edges here, and we're going to just wrap it around our box. We're going to do it in the back. Actually, you know what? Let's start in the front. This one I did start in the back, but as you see, there's like a little seam where it overlapped. We are going to cover this up completely. So I'm going to go ahead and start in the front. Now, your front is where your piece is curved around. So my seams are in the back here, so that's my back. So I'm going to actually start in the front. I'm going to start right in the middle, and I'm just kind of lining it up, centered top and bottom. And I'm just going to go around and just kind of pinch and adhere it all the way around. If you wanted to kind of do this before you put the adhesive on it, you could absolutely do that. Just kind of pinch it, and so you know it kind of dry fit it. But you know, I live on the wild side. You'll see that doesn't match up perfectly, but we're going to cover that up anyway, so I'm not worried about it. So I'm just going to go through and just really kind of pinch these little corners so they're nice and sharp. You can see how gorgeous that DSP is. All right, for our stamping, we're going to use a brand new Sale-a-Bration stamp set. This is the Counting Sheep Sale-a-Bration stamp set. So this is a little sneak peek into Sale-a-Bration. This is one you're going to be able to earn for free with a $50 purchase. You can get this one for free, but you guys, it gets so much better because look, there's dies that coordinate with it. This is also in the Sale-a-Bration catalog. This is also free with a $50 purchase. So if you spend $100, you can get both of these items for free during Sale-a-Bration in August and September. So super cute. So this is what we're using today. We're using the Counting Sheep stamp set and the sheep dies, both of them available during Sale-a-Bration. So for my little sheep, I just have a scrap piece of white here. We're going to stamp our little sheep with Memento. We're going to do some coloring with some Stampin' Blends. So we're going to color him with Memento, or stamp him with Memento. Okay, look how cute he is. Oh my goodness. All right. And put that off to the side, And I'm going to bring in my Stampin' Blends. I'm only using a couple colors here. I have Smoky Slate Light and Dark, Petal Pink Light and Dark, and then I have my Color Lifter. So let's start with our Smoky Slate. I'm actually going to start with my Light Smoky Slate, and I'm going to use this on the sheep's little, what do you call it, wool? I guess it's wool. It's not fur. Sheep don't have fur. So I'm just going around with my Light Smoky Slate, just kind of, going around the outside, and there are little marks from the artist where there would be a little bit of shadow, so I'm definitely hitting those marks. Let's see those back here along his leg. I'm not being super neat about it. Just kind of adding some texture around his arm here. There we go. Now I'm going to go in with my Color Lifter, and I'm going to use circular motions and just kind of blend that out from the edge. And that's just going to kind of soften the look of those blends. They're not going to be like a harsh line, but they are going to leave some shading and some texture. So it's going to look like your sheep has some shadows in his wool, and he's not going to be completely white, which, you know, most sheep, I don't think, are completely white. I don't have a lot of experience with sheep in person, so I'm not sure. But this will give some lots of shading and texture to our little sheep. I'm just kind of pulling out that color with our Color Lifter. All right, now that's gonna dry, and then we'll be able to see all those, that shading a little bit better. Now with my Dark Smoky Slate, I'm gonna go in on his hooves, and I'm just coloring those. They are a small little area. I don't think that you need to go crazy with blending on his hooves. You can if you want, but I'm just coloring them with the dark and calling it a day. All right, now for his little face, I'm using Petal Pink. So we're gonna start with Petal Pink Dark. And I'm gonna go around where the wool is overlapping his face. That's gonna be the darkest area. So I'm just gonna make sure to darken that area a little bit. And on all of his arms, just where it meets his body, I'm going in with the dark. And then I'm taking my light, and again, in circular motions, I'm just gonna blend out that dark. So his nose is going to be the lightest area. And I'm just blending in his legs just a little bit. All right, and if you want to go back in with the dark petal pink, you can. Just darken up that a little bit. Oh, and his ears. Forgot his ears. It's a little bit of dark on each little end, and then just go in with the light and just kind of blend that out. There we go, and there is our cute little sheep. See, he's super cute. I love him. All right, so that is all of the coloring on that. So let's get our dyes. We're going to die cut him with our dyes. I've already done some other die cutting in advance, so I'll get all of those out and show you what I've done. So let me tape him down. I'm going to use some post-it tape to hold down my die so he doesn't move in our die cutting machine. And I've also used the same sheep dyes. I've cut out the fence. We're going to use a fence. And I have cut out two balloons that come in the die. There's some balloons, flags, suns, clouds. There's lots of fun little dies in here. So I've cut that out of basic gray, and I have cut that out from fresh freesia as well. So we have two balloons. For the tailored tag dies, these are in the annual catalog. I've already pre-cut a tag and then the little reinforcer for the tag. And then for my greeting, I've already heat embossed this in white. So I stamped it in Versamark, covered it with the white heat embossing powder, and I've heat embossed this in white. And this little tag, this little die cut tag, is from the, oh, I don't think I've got it out. It's from the Pretty Pillow Box dies. Let me see if I can find those really quick. We're going to be using those on Wednesday, so I will show you them on Wednesday, but it's also in the new annual or the new holiday catalog. Okay, so let me move these out of the way. I'm going to pull in my mini cut and emboss. You can use your larger one if you have that handy. I'm going to pull this one in, and we're just going to die cut our little sheep. Love this little machine. This is a great purchase during Sale-a-Bration. It's $60. You can earn a free Sale-a-Bration item with this. Move that out of the way. We have our little sheep ready to go. So let's pull him out. Oh, look how cute. Okay. So now we just have to assemble everything. So I forgot to pull my ribbon down. Man, you guys, just when I thought I had it all together. So I'm just going to use a little bit of liquid glue. This is my Tombow liquid glue, just to adhere that little reinforcer up there. So just line that up nice and straight. We're going to set this aside to dry. Now for my balloon, I have one in basic gray, and then I cut one out in fresh freesia. I'm just going to cut the little tail off of this one. We don't need that. We just want the balloon. And I'm going to glue the fresh freesia balloon over the basic gray, and that will give us like a two-toned balloon. So we have the string in one color and the balloon a different color. So I'm going to set that aside to dry. And let's work on the rest of our tag. So I have our little fence. This is going to go right up against our tag. So I'm going to add a little bit of liquid glue to this. You can use glue dots, or you can use our adhesive sheets if you wanted to glue them down that way if you're not a fan of liquid glue. And I lost my words for a second. And you'll see I didn't put glue on the whole thing because this is going to hang off a little bit. So I'm going to end up trimming that. So pull in my scissors and just whatever is hanging off. I cut that off in these little posts over here too. I'm going to cut off. Okay, so here's our little fence. We have our sheep. He's going to be dancing right here. So we're going to stick him on with some dimensionals. I have some little mini ones today. But any dimensionals will be fine. Now I did mention that I was going to go live on Wednesday. So I'll be live on Wednesday morning at 10 a.m. just like today, and I'll be showing another sneak peek from the new mini catalog, some Sale-a-Bration products, all of that. I'm showing new stuff all week long. I'll also be live on Friday morning as well. Now to adhere our balloon, I'm going to put one dimensional on the back of the balloon, and I'm just going to put a little dot on his little hoof. That's where the string is going to overlap. We're going to peel off our little dimensional here. And we're going to stick on our little balloon just like that. Make sure the string grabs that glue. All right, last thing is our greeting. Now I just need to trim this off close to that amazing, close to the A and you're amazing. We're just going to kind of hover this over just like that. I'm going to put a little bit of glue on the little tip of the tag. That's going to overhang on the sheep. And I'm just going to put a dimensional right on the tag where it's going to lay on the tag, just so everything sits at the same height. Oh my goodness, I'm like fumbling. This is just gonna go on our tag just like that. Super cute, isn't that adorable? We're almost done. All right, we are going to add some ribbon. This is also brand new ribbon in our new catalog. This is our glittered organdy ribbon. This is our white. So if you have our black organdy ribbon, our glittered one, it is similar to that. It is gorgeous. So this is the white version of it. I'm not going to tie a knot to first. I'm just going to make a loop and tie my little bow around that loop. Hold on. Oh my gosh, you guys. Why do I put myself through tying bows on camera? I don't know why I do it. So I'm holding my loop. I'm just going to wrap it around. And then right here where my finger is, I'm just going to push another loop through. And by not tying a knot, we're really cutting down on the bulk. Sometimes this more bulky ribbon can really add a lot of bulk, even on a 3D project. So we have our little bow there. Without a knot, it sits nice and flat. Now, if you love this ribbon is actually going to be included in the August card crate, the Hand Pen Petals card crate. So you'll get a roll of this in the card crate. Okay. We are almost done. We need to just stick this onto our box. We're of course going to use dimensionals for that. So let me just put some dimensionals down the center of our box here. And then we have one more little step to make our balloon just stand out just a little bit more. So let's stick that down onto our box. Okay, now for our balloon, I'm going to cover it with, this is our shimmery crystal effects. This is kind of a hidden gem in our annual catalog, but it is like shimmery, liquid, clear glue. So we used to sell crystal effects a long time ago, but this one is shimmery. So there is like little pieces of glitter in there. It really makes stuff sparkle and shine. So it does take a few minutes to dry. I definitely would set this aside for I mean, even upwards of maybe like an hour to dry. You'll see that it's a little bit cloudy at first, but once it's completely dry, it's gonna be nice and shimmery and glossy. It almost gives it like an enamel effect. It's really, really cool. So you're gonna set this one aside to dry. I'll make sure to put that in a safe place. Don't put anything on top of it, of course, but there is our cute little treat box. Isn't that adorable? With our little counting sheep stamps that, remember, you can get this and the dies for free. There's little treats inside. Just a sweet little easy box. You can make this for anybody in your life. This would be great little favors too for a party. All right, guys, thank you guys so much for joining me. Remember, I will be live. Oh, do you guys want a sneak peek? We're gonna, I mentioned that little pillow box die. So this is what we're making. Oh, that's all you get. I'm gonna show you guys how to make those on Wednesday. I'm gonna sneak peek that on Wednesday. If you have any questions on anything, please let me know. If you need to order any supplies, please head to my online store. If you're watching this on Facebook, I'd love it if you shared it with your friends. If you're on YouTube, please like and subscribe to my channel. Again, if you have any questions, please let me know. Otherwise, I will see you guys on Wednesday at 10 a.m. right here. Thanks, guys. I'll see you later. Bye.